Next, a gentleman of great accomplishment. In fact, of the categories that I mentioned, people who could win or be recipients of the Hall of Fame, he covers two and possibly three. Ladies and gentlemen, please make welcome on the stage one of the greatest air show pilots and greatest creators of unique aircraft, our pal Steve Wolf. Steve, right here, if you would.
Steve Wolf could have easily been inducted into the Hall of Fame for either one of his two distinct airshow careers. After soloing at the age of 14 and becoming a certified flight instructor 2 weeks after his 18th birthday, Steve was a professional airshow pilot by the time he turned 20, performing a solo routine in an Aranca Champ during the early 1970s. Already a nationally recognized performer by the mid-1970s, he received an invitation from King Hussein of Jordan in 1976 to form the country's new national aerobatic team. The Royal Jordanian Falcon started originally as a two-ship act, adding a third pit special while Steve was still performing with the group. Following that two-year stint in Jordan, Steve returned to the United States and joined Steve Soper in the late 70s and early 80s to form a two-ship pits act, the Northern Knights. And it was about that time that Steve opened his own company, Wolf Aircraft, and began the second chapter of his airshow career. Since 1978, Wolf has designed and built some of the world's most iconic airshow aircraft. Using his experience as an airshow performer and his talent for designing high-performance aerobatic aircraft, he developed a reputation for building airplanes that are both beautiful and functional. Although he stopped flying airshows more than 30 years ago, his impact on our business has never been greater. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to ICAS, the newest member of the ICAS Foundation Airshow Hall of Fame, Steve Wolf.
Steve, congratulations, old buddy. Way to go.
Holy cow, it makes me tired just seeing all that. You know, all I can say is my life's really been the pits. But that's a good thing. You know, I'm so blessed to have my son, Stephen Mark, and my daughter, Christine Amelia, and my wife, Kathy Hertz, over here, who was one of my, Kathy was one of my students. She became my boss when she hired me as chief pilot of Wing Over Aerobatics, and then she became an air show pilot, and then she hired me, or I mean, we got married, and when we got married, I noticed one thing. I quit getting paychecks, so that kind of died. You know, I want to really thank ICAS for everything they've done. My first ICAS was in 1976 in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. And so, you know, over 43 years, I've seen a lot of things happen. And, you know, ICAS, one thing I can say that's really been good over the years is it's helped between the sponsors and producers and performers and everything. It's really managed to still have entertainment out there all over the world that people can go enjoy good wholesome entertainment and just get their faces away from iPads and iPhones for at least 2 hours or 4 hours and stuff. And I have to tell you, when I first got, you performers will understand this more than anything. When I got my first aerobatic competency, I'd already flown one show without, the FAA never asked about it back in 1969 when I was 19, but I went to my next air show up in Seattle. The FISDO there said, hey, you know what? He says, where's your aerobatic competency letter? And I said, a what? You know, and they said, well, you gotta have it, you can't fly. So one of the other performers said, it's great, go ahead, or he's a good guy, let him fly. So they did, that's back in those days. And so I went back and I went to Tom Taylor of the Portland FISDO. I was out in the Northwest there. And I went in to see about getting my aerobatic competency. He asked me what I did. I told him how I'd shut the engine off, spin, loop, roll that, and then do a snap roll at 150 feet on final and land on one wheel, all with the prop stopped. He sat at his desk, he looked at me. He just spun around in his chair, got on his typewriter, typed me out an aerobatic competency, hands it to me and says, now, you know, Steve, this expires in a year, so if you're still alive next year, I'll give you a new one or give you or renew it. And that, you know, that was the FAA back then. You know, he never even went out and watched me fly, you know. He just, well, you'd already done a show kind of thing. And, of course, that has led to what it does today, working up and creating a very safe environment, you know, for air shows. people. And my in my case, man, my parents were so great. They let me spend more time at the airport than home. So that was good. The guy that ran Vancouver Fly-In Service in Washington State, he gave me a job, let me fly and trade for flying lessons. He also let me work in the shop, so I started getting, you know, used to being around airplanes. One day he gave me something to do, and I says, I can't do that. He says, what'd you say? I said, I can't do it. And he says, well, can't never did a damn thing. If you tell yourself that, you'll never do it. So that really, he, listen to things and listen to elders, I actually got some self-confidence, which actually allowed me to fly shows later. It's like a can-do attitude. And so when Weiss T. Coleman III called me and says, hey, Steve, can you build an airplane out for him, Sean D. Tucker's? I said, sure I can, because I'd been working on Sean's stuff since 93. You can always outdo yourself. So, you know, but after Sean flew Weiss's airplane, he says, well, I got to have one. And what a lot of people don't realize is Sean's Oracle Challenger 3 is actually Wolfbitz Pro serial number 2. And it's actually going to this with 8 ailerons on it. And I can get into that. I won't get into that. I only got a few minutes to talk. But anyway, you know, the aircraft's on its way to the Smithsonian, so I finally get an airplane hanging in the Smithsonian. So I'm really getting some honors this year. This is a incredible one and stuff. And of course, a relationship with Curtis Pitts. He was not only a mentor and an inspiration, he was also Kathy's and my best man at my wedding in a hot air balloon. And I was told there'd never be a dull moment marrying Kathy. And you know, I did one of my first shows in my pits when my mother watched me fly. I overheard after the show her friend say, doesn't it bother you, Steve, up there doing that kind of stuff that close to the ground? You know what my mother said? She says, no, I got 3 other sons. And so I want to leave it in closing with just not the 3 things you know, 3 things that air show performers should know. There's a lot more to it than 3 things. Just remember this advice. If you're close to the ground, you want to really be going fast. If you're slow, be high, and where to get your paycheck. So that's the 3 things I advise. I really want to thank ICAS Foundation, and for all the years and the thrills it's given me, and my life is really, I can't imagine it any other way. And it really has meant a lot to me. This award's incredible. Thank you so very much.
Thank you, Steve.